Every year, many hundreds of motorists passing through Bristol on their journey between the Midlands and the Southwest stop to look at one of the West Country's most celebrated landmarks, the Clifton Suspension Bridge. Spanning the gorge of the River Avon, 250 feet above river level, this bridge, in its design and natural setting, must surely be one of the loveliest bridges in the world. Built to link the Bristol and Somerset sides of the river, it is made of stone and iron, for it was designed long before the days of steel and concrete. Every year, hundreds of gallons of paint, red for the ironwork and yellow for the masonry, are used to preserve intact the original structure, and so well has the work been done that the fabric of the bridge is as good today as when it was first built. The painters need to have a good head for heights and sure foot, and there have been some lucky escapes. Here one of the bridge painters, Gilbert Taylor, shows a young visitor the spot where, in trying to retrieve a sightseer's overcoat, he slipped and fell 80 feet into the woods below. His only injuries were two broken ribs and bruises. Even more remarkable, children, who on a stormy September night in 1896 were thrown from the centre of their bridge by their father in a fit of insanity. They fell the full 250 feet into the river below, where a passing boat picked them up, shocked but unhurt. The graceful shape of the bridge is due to the six sets of great chains from which the roadway hangs. These huge curving chains, made up of over 4,000 forged iron links, carry the full weight of the bridge. In design, they are rather like bicycle chains, only the links are longer, and instead of two links, they have 10, 11, or 12 links to a length. At each end of the bridge, these chains disappear 70 feet down into the solid rock, where they are firmly anchored. From here, they are carried upward and over the 80-foot high towers, or piers as they are more properly called, which they cross on heavy iron rollers. Between the towers, the chains hang by their own weight in a natural curve or catenary, and workmen find them the easiest way to reach the top of the towers.